As of October 15th of 2023, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is Indonesia's infamous Krakatau volcano, which began a new, moderately explosive eruption on October 9th, ejecting ash and bombs of lava into the air via Volcanian explosions. Krakatoa's newest cone, termed Anak Krakatoa, has been intermittently growing since 1927, now covering an area of 3.24 square kilometers. The Krakatoa volcano has produced two very large explosive eruptions in the last 2,000 years, which formed calderas in both 540 and 1883. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. Within Alaska, the alert level was changed at the state's second tallest volcano, Mount Wrangell. Meanwhile, in Russia, the near-perfectly symmetrical Klyuchevskoy volcano repeatedly produced a phenomenon known as a smoke ring. And, in what is this week's top story, the world's newest volcanic island, aka the Home Reef volcano, has continued to expand through yet another volcanic eruption. Tonga's Home Reef volcano can be found approximately 24 kilometers south-southwest of the uninhabited island of Leyte. Home Reef's latest island formed during a 38-day-long eruption which began in September of 2022, which created a 50,000 square meter or 12.4 acre island that measured 275 meters wide. Unlike many prior peripheral islands created by the same volcano, this island was constructed out of a dacite lava dome, so it was fairly resistant to erosion. Well, on September 24th, 2023, this volcano erupted again, and in the 22 days since, additional lava flows have grown the island primarily along a north-south axis by a total of 190 meters or 623 feet. This has expanded Home Reef by an additional 9.5 acres as viscous dacite lava continues to erupt at an estimated rate of 0.2 cubic meters per second. This eruption is likely to continue for several more days to weeks, so this island is likely to further expand. Regardless, in my opinion, I would recommend keeping a minimum distance of 4 kilometers away from this volcanic island's coastline by ship, and to avoid flying directly over this island in case its eruption produces an explosive phase. Meanwhile, in Alaska, the alert level was changed at the fourth tallest volcano in the entirety of the United States. There, the summit of the glacier-covered Mount Wrangell stands at a height of 14,163 feet above sea level. Yet, the alert level was not exactly raised at this voluminous andesitic shield volcano. Instead, Wrangell experienced a problem all too common on volcanoes with abundant glaciers and or thick snowfall. Simply put, the monitoring stations on this tall volcano ceased working on October 13, 2023, meaning they were either damaged or destroyed by lightning, glacial movement, or completely buried underneath ever-shifting glacier ice and snow so that a signal could not be transmitted. As a result, Wrangell's alert level on the same date was changed from green indicating normal volcanic activity with nothing unusual to white or unassigned indicating that we no longer have sufficient information to determine this volcano's state of activity. Since these advanced sensors are fairly expensive, often costing in the six-figure range, there is a cost-benefit analysis where they are generally only placed on the most active or potentially dangerous volcanoes. However, since Wrangell is considered an important complex to monitor, new equipment is likely to be brought onto or repaired on the volcano, meaning it should return to an alert level of green at some point in the next 12 months. And in Russia, the towering 15,597 foot or 4,754 meter tall Klyuchevskoy volcano has been continuing its Strombolian eruption, which is now in its fifth month. However, on October 12th, it produced a series of circular puffs of volcanic gas referred to as smoke rings, sending a several hundred foot wide ring of rotating gases into the sky. The production of these rings was made possible by the mostly circular vent Klyuchevskoy summit contains. These smoke rings are produced when rising volcanic gas gets compressed into a narrowing vent. A large gas bubble then develops, and significant water vapor which is present subsequently rushes out to escape, but is blocked by the gas bubble, causing the formation of a large ring. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on October 15th of 2023. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Craig Ward, for supporting this channel.